Concepts of electrical. Now, what are the modules that we have to undergo? Let us just see first what the modules are all about this subject. So this will be the starting of your syllabus that we will be having for the first part, that is module one. So module one will be dealing with DC circuits and AC fundamentals. So that this is what I was talking about, DC and AC. I think you have some portions are common, you have studied earlier, but this is more into depth into those things, especially the laws. So what are they? The Ohm's law, the Kirchhoff's law, the analysis of the series and parallel circuits, as well as series parallel combination of circuits, and that to the different expressions of power and energy will be involved. And then we'll go to AC fundamentals. So let me just start this first module, module one. So before beginning the DC circuits, I just want you all to know the basic parameters of electrical engineering. That is what? The voltage, current, and the different parameters. So voltage, current, I know you already know about it. You have studied in basic electronics also, a bit of it. But here, why it is important? Because there are certain limitations about the laws. There are certain consideration or assumptions about the laws that you need to know. So what is electric current? We all know that. I'm just going brushing the basics up once again. That is any particle or any matter, for example, it consists of atoms, we know. Okay, so atoms consist of three basic particles: protons, electrons, and neutrons. I know this is very basic still, because I know again problems will be coming. That is why I'm just brushing up the basics. So electrons, protons, and neutrons, they consist of an atom. Atom consists of them. So in the atom, there is the nucleus portion. We have P and N, that is protons and the neutrons. Okay, and outside EEE in the orbits, it is moving. Those are the electrons. So the outermost regions of the atoms are called electron shells, and they contain the electrons. Electrons are negatively charged, and in the nucleus, the P or the protons, they are positively charged. Now, what is charge? When does charge happen? What actually occurs? The concept of electric charge. The total deficiency or addition of excess electrons in an atom is called as charge. So you see an atom, whenever this atom is not stabilized or not in neutral form, when that happens? When any electron is added or removed from this atom. When any electrons, the outermost orbital shells, the E's that is written in circles, if that is removed or added, the atom gets charged. Okay, so charge is what? The total deficiency or addition of excess electrons in an atom, that is called charge. Okay, so when does an atom said to be charged? When any electron is added into it or removed from it. Okay, and charged atoms are known as ions. This is important because cations and anions, those are the different kinds of ions. So charged atoms are known as ions. Okay, so when from an atom, it loses the negative charge and the atom becomes positively charged, it is known as cation. And if excess electron is added to an atom, it becomes negatively charged and is known as anion. So anion and cation are the two types of ions. Next, we have electromotive force or EMF and current. Okay, so EMF also is known to you still. An electrical effort to drift the free electrons in one particular direction in a conductor is called electromotive force. Okay, it is measured in volts. Okay, now the direction depends on how the external electric effort is applied. Means, suppose you have a conductor, okay, in what direction you are applying the EMF, depending upon that, current will flow. Okay, in what direction? In one direction you are putting positive to negative, negative to positive. Now this is the basic thing, whether current flows from negative to positive or positive to negative. Anyone can answer?
Negative to positive.
Okay. Okay, there are conventions, I'll go on to that later. Let's move. So here is a conductor upon which a voltage is applied. Okay, applied voltage is there. You can see the direction of the flow. So it is nothing but a battery. If you can see clearly, it is a battery. Across a battery, a particle charge means a material or conductor is put, and we see that how much the current, in which direction they flow. So when, suppose there is this conductor which consists of plus and minus, positive and negative things. Okay, so when a free electron gets dragged towards the positive, means the positive voltage, you see the longer line of the battery that is positive and the shorter line of the battery that is negative. Okay, so we see that if the positive side is applied to the left side and the negative, the shorter ones, is applied to the right side. So in this conditions, the free electron gets dragged into the positive from an atom, and it becomes positively charged ion, and such positive ion drags a free electron from the next atom, and this process repeats from atom to atom. Means dragging of the free electrons, it is a cumulative action. If once it starts, it will happen to the next atom, then to the next atom. It will start in a cumulative way, and this process will be repeated from atom to atom along the entire conductor. Now this movement, or the flow of electrons from negative to positive of the cell externally through the conductor across which the cell is connected, cell means the battery is connected, is called the electric current. So what does it mean? It means that whenever the direction, whatever is the direction of the charge, opposite is the direction of the electric current. Okay. So direction of the charge, in which direction they are moving, opposite is the movement of electric current. So this movement or flow of electrons from negative to positive of the cell, that is called electric current. Okay, so moving on to the next one. Oh, okay, I think it ends here. Just wait a bit, let me just tell you more about the atoms. People are joining even now. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, good. So yes, you see, okay, fine, thank you. So this is about the notes that I'll give you later. For now, let us concentrate on what we were talking about. This is the electromotive force and the current. Okay, so it says that when a free electron gets dragged towards the positive from an atom, it becomes positively charged ion. So such positive ion drags a free electron from the next atom. This process repeats from atom to atom along the conductor, and this movement or flow of electrons from negative to positive of the cycle externally through the conductor across which the cell is connected is called as electric current. Okay. So this is about the electric current, of what are the electric currents, how it flows, it is all about that. Now, I hope you are present with pen and paper, everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good, very good. Those who are not, I'll request you that, okay, this is the first class. Maybe you are not aware. From the next class onwards, please be present with pen and paper. This is online class, just like classroom coaching, okay? So it is the same thing. I'll just move on to the next one. Now, this says the relation between charge and current. Okay, charge and current. Now, we know that what is charge, and we just came to know what is current. Mathematically, the expression goes as current equals to charge by T. Now, what is T? T is the time required for the transfer of charge. So, basically, the definition wise, current can be defined as the rate of flow of charge in an electric circuit or in any medium in which charges are subjected to an electric external field. Okay, again, I'm telling the current can be defined as the rate of flow of charge. So current is basically rate of flow of charge. So how is any rate defined? Divided by T, obviously. Okay, so obviously any rate is defined with respect to time. So if charge is the current is the rate of flow of charge, then current is equals to charge by time, I equals to Q by T, where I holds as the average current flowing, Q is the total charge transferred, and small t is the time required for the transfer. Okay, now the unit of current is ampere. I hope you know. If you do not, then this ampere can be defined as like this: 1 ampere. Okay, a current of 1 ampere is said to be flowing in the conductor when a charge of 1 coulomb is passing any given point on it in 1 second. So that charge that passes in 1 second, that is what 1 ampere is about. Okay. Now moving to the electric potential and the potential difference, very, very important. I mean, important concept-wise. Okay. So every charged particle has a tendency to do work, that is to attract or repel. What is the work? Obviously, the work is any work done by anybody is what? Any action, motion, movement, then only we can say work. Okay, so that work of the charge is what? Charged particle to attract or to repel. Like, you know, like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other. So that is the work done by the charged particle. Okay, so the ability of a charged particle to do work is called its electric potential. So what is the difference between electric potential, potential difference, and voltage? These three, everyone gets confused, or they ask, are they the same thing? No, they are not the same thing. Electric potential is something, and obviously, you see, just imagine the flow of water or any fluid. Obviously, it takes place from a higher slope to a lower slope. You have two levels, so obviously, it will go down from up to low. Means from higher side to lower side, it will flow. It is same in case of potential. Potential, just imagine them as two levels. Okay. Now, what is potential difference? The height that it is giving, the upper and difference between the upper and lower, that is the height. That is actually the potential difference. Means difference of the two levels. And level, that levels are the potentials. Okay. So this is an example. Now let's go back. Every charged particle has the tendency to work, as I said, and this ability of a charged particle to do work is called its electric potential. The unit of electric potential is volt. Obviously, if you have something like, I say, I'll just give an example. If you have two, like, all the examples that are coming in my mind is basically electrical. I don't want to give electrical example. Suppose you are having two number of apples. Okay, two apples you are having. So, or let us consider three apples. So, if you remove them, if you remove two apples from three apples, one apple will be remaining. Okay, so both are the number of apples. They do not have units. So, suppose I will just try giving example of potatoes, like 3 kgs of potatoes. Okay, see, 3 kgs of potatoes, you remove 2 kgs of potatoes. So what is the difference? 1 kg. 1 kg is a difference, right? So its unit is also kg. So if you have two levels, their units are in volt, so the difference also will be in volt. So that is why their units are in volt, but that doesn't mean they are the same thing. Are you getting my point?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is about
Yes,
just
ma'am.
the example. Okay. Thank you. Now, this is about the electric potential and potential difference. Potential difference is in electric circuits, the flow of current is always from higher electric potential to lower electric potential. The difference between the electric potentials at any two given points in a circuit is known as potential difference. This is also called as voltage. Now, potential difference is the voltage. Do you get it? Because the potential is potential itself. But the difference in the levels, that is our voltage or that is our potential difference. Now, when electric current flows, that means there are potential difference. That is why the current is flowing. If the two ends are of same potential, suppose it is a horizontal level, what same equal uniform level, will water be flowing? No, water will not be flowing because they are at ground level. It is uniform level. Now, if there is difference occurs, the slope is slightly higher or slightly lower from one side or another, then water will flow. Same as the electric current. If there is potential difference, then only current will flow, electric current will flow. Otherwise, electric current will not flow. Okay, so to make the electric current flow, potential difference or voltage is required. If there is voltage, then only it will flow. If there is no voltage, then it will not flow. Okay, clear? The difference
Ma'am.
between. Yes, because the differences are important. Potential, electric potential and potential difference are not the same thing. Okay. Now, you must note this thing. Note means just remember that to maintain the flow of electrons, that is, flow of electric current, there must exist a potential difference between the two points. No current can flow if the potential difference between the two points is zero. Just as I said, if the potential difference is zero, no current can flow. Okay? Okay. Now moving to the circuit elements. This is something you can write down, like what are the circuit elements? It's very important. That is, when you will be given any electric circuit. Now, first of all, what is a circuit? Circuit is the one through which electric current flows. Okay? Electric current flows through something, that means that is a circuit. Okay? Now, there are many elements in the circuit. What are they? The main two classifications of elements, how should we identify or how should we distinguish between these two? One which consumes power, one which dissipates power. Okay? No, I think I said the same thing. Consumption and dissipation is same thing. One which gives rise to the power, that is the source of power, and one which consumes or dissipates the power. Okay, so just an example or just the classification. Circuit elements are active components or active elements or passive components of passive elements. Okay, so what are the active components? those components which actually I said the source of power, those are the active, they create the power. Just like in the circuit you saw the battery. So battery in that circuit actually acts as the source or the active component. Okay, and the conductor that you see, that was the passive component. Okay, so active component, these are able to inject power or to source, act as a source of power into the circuit, and are capable of controlling the flow of electric current because they are the ones that produce the current, right? They are create, not exactly producing, I should say. I should say that, okay, they are causing the potential difference. Okay, so these are able to inject power into a circuit and are capable of controlling the flow of electric current. And the passive elements or passive components, these are not capable of injecting or controlling the flow of current. They either consume or store energy. Now, why are these two said consume? Consume means you are just dissipating it. And store means what are the things that store? Any idea? It's already written. I'm just telling you. Okay, no need to. Resistors are the ones where entire power gets dissipated. And capacitors and inductors store power. They store electric power. Okay. So, not power, energy. Okay, fine. Energy. So, resistors, capacitors, and inductors, transformers also, they are examples of such passive components. And active components examples are like in DC, it is a cell or battery in DC. And in AC, amplifiers like transistors, diodes, triodes, vacuum tubes, valves, these are the examples. Like if you see a diagram, like suppose you see a coil-like structures. So when you see the coil-like structure, it will be something like a bulb or an inductor. Okay. So you need to identify that, okay, this is something that is consuming power, so that is passive. Okay. Now when you see the signs, I'll just go to the signs, conventional signs of representing the elements, that is the active elements and the passive elements. So just let's move on to that. I've just defined energy sources like the cell and battery. I said these are of two types of energy sources, voltage source and current source. They can be again further classified as ideal and practical sources, but basically voltage source and current source, the signs you will see means this how they are represented, that signs will be shown. And this resistance, I hope you all know from the Ohm's law. Ohm's law, it comes. This is something that is definitely coming in the, what should I say, VTU SEM exams, that is state Ohm's law and its limitations. It's a compulsory question every year. So it comes this way or the other. So from Ohm's law only we get the resistance. So what is resistance? The property of an electric circuit opposing the flow of current at the same time causing electrical energy to be converted to heat is called resistance. So we see resistance or resistors. I think you have seen in electronics also how they look like. In the labs, it is seen easily. So resistors are something where we it opposes, which opposes the flow of current, and at the same time it causes the electrical energy to be converted to heat. Okay, means it dissipates electrical energies. In simple words, it consumes and dissipates. There is nothing to store here in resistance. Next is the voltage sources that I was talking about. Like just the source example I gave, like battery or cell, that can be ideal or can be practical. So, how to define that? Ideal voltage source. Ideal voltage sources are, or ideal voltage source is defined as the energy source which gives constant voltage across its terminals, irrespective of the current that is drawn through the terminals. First, everyone, I'll just request you see the circuit. You can draw the circuit also. In the left-hand side, the diagram, that is the diagram of the circuit. Okay, so that diagram of the circuit VS, the one which is written as VS, that is our voltage source. It is represented by this circle, and outside or inside plus and minus is given. So plus and minus sign decides in which direction you are considering the current. So we consider it like this. It starts from the plus and it ends the minus, and in which direction it is going, that I'll say later. I'll say first, this is an electric circuit in what I want to say. So this electric circuit will give us this graph, the graph that is seen in the right-hand side, because it is an ideal voltage source that gives constant voltage. That is why a flat straight line, it gives a constant voltage. Now, electric voltage or ideal voltage source is one which gives constant voltage across its terminals, irrespective of whatever the current is drawn through its terminals. So, why is it ideal? Because it is a straight line. But does ideal voltage source exist in reality? No. No. Okay. So, I'll just say about the ideal source. Ideal source is defined as the energy source which gives constant voltage across its terminals, irrespective of the current drawn through the terminals. That is what it says. Now, practically, we do not get it like that. Practically, this is what that happens. Practically, every voltage source has small internal resistance, that is in series. It has always means if you give any voltage source, it is never that pure that it will give a straight line. It is in practical case, it is always some amount of resistance that is present there. So that small amount of resistance that is in series, connected in series, that we consider it, that is our voltage source. So practically every voltage source has this small amount of internal resistance shown, and whenever internal resistance is shown, the straight line that we saw, that flat constant voltage it was giving, it will not give that, because obviously it is a the graph is voltage versus current. Okay, so it is consuming. Okay, as the current is increasing, the voltage is decreasing inversely proportional linearly. So this is the case of practical case, or rather from ideal to practical variations. As you can see from the graph, in ideal it was a straight line, in practical it is a slanted line. So this is all about our concept of practical voltage source. So this is practical voltage source, where every voltage source has a small amount of internal resistance. Okay, so I'll not go to this equation now, because you may not understand. Just understand the notations. VS is our voltage source. RSE is the series internal resistance. RL is the load resistance. Everything you add in the circuit becomes a passive component apart from the voltage source. So just remember, apart from voltage source, if anything is there, that means it is our passive element. Okay, so is this understandable by all? Just raise question if you do not understand anything. Anyone has any questions? No. Okay, so moving on to this one, resistance. So unit of resistance is ohm. Okay, it is denoted by ohm. I already stated about the definition of resistance, that is the property of an electric circuit opposing the flow of current and at the same time causing electrical energy to be converted to heat energy, is called resistance. Now, higher the availability of free electrons, lesser will be the opposition to the flow of current. Obviously, because R, or resistance, is inversely proportional to current, because it is opposing the current. Resistance is something that opposes the current, right? So if more current flows, that means resistance is small. If resistance is large, less amount of current will flow. Okay, so denoted by R and measured in ohm, it is symbolically represented as ohm, the symbol that is given, that is ohm. Okay, so 1 ohm, the 1 ohm resistance can be defined as the resistance of a circuit in which a current of 1 ampere generates the heat at the rate of 1 joules per second is said to be 1 ohm. So, 1 joule in 1 second means 1 ohm. The heat is 1 joule, and per second it is producing that is said to be 1 ohm. Now, the factors affecting the resistance, this I think you have studied earlier. So, we all know this formula, capital R equals to rho L by A. We know this formula. So I'll just briefing that formula. Resistance can be affected by these factors, that is the length of the material, how resistance is directly proportional to length L. Cross-sectional area, capital R, is directly proportional to 1 by A, 1 by area. Type of material, whether it is a conductor or an insulator, upon that also resistance can be decided upon. And the last one is the temperature. That formula was also in physics, if you remember. So ultimately, what we can infer that R is proportional to L by A. So R is equals to rho L by A, where rho is the constant of proportionality and rho is termed as resistivity. So I think I'll leave here. Everyone clear till now, whatever I have taught in this class? Is everything clear? Okay. So I'll be going the next one in the next class. I'll not be proceeding too much today because this is the first class, you need to know. I'll be leaving here. Before that, I'll just call the roll number. So just respond kindly, everyone. I hope I am audible to you, right?
Yes,
Yes,
ma'am.
ma'am.
Yes,
Yes.
sir.
So I'm just
Yes, ma'am.
calling the roll number. Respond. Just when I call the names, you just respond. Two 01, Amrita.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. 202, Anand Bhavya. 202, Anand Bhavya Kocher, is there? No. So 202 is absent. Fine. 203, Anil Lamani. Not present. 204, Mohammad Shahid.
Ma'am,
You are present in the class or you just joined again? Okay. So today's class, I am just leaving, not taking that seriously, the attendance, although I know that many of you left while it was going on. So 204, Mohammad Shazib, present? Mohammad Shazib? 204, Mohammad Shazib? Again absent. Okay. 205, Monish Virbhadra Wadigar.
प्रेजेंट
Okay, fine. 206, Om Nakul Sindagi.
मैम
Okay. 207, Sangmesh. 207, Sangmesh. I saw him leaving the meeting. Okay. 208, Santosh Badigar.
मैम
Okay. 209, Saurabh Sunil Ghodake.
प्रेजेंट मैम
ओके 210 अनिल कुमार पाटिल,
यस मैम।
ओके 211 आशीष, 211 आशीष धुरी नॉट प्रेजेंट, ओके 212 प्रीतम,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके फाइन 213 रोहित,
यस मैम।
ओके फाइन 214 सागर,
यस मैम।
ओके 215 ऐश्वर्या, ओके
प्रेजेंट मैम।
216 अक्षता, 217
प्रेजेंट मैम।
अमृता,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
219 219 आनंद, हाँ
प्रेजेंट
ओके 219 चंदन,
मैम। यस मैम।
ओके फाइन 220 यू आर राइट,
यस मैम।
ओके 221 चंद्रभाग कामकर, चंद्रभाग एकनाथ कामकर 221, 221
यस मैम प्रेजेंट।
ओके 222 चन्ना बासव,
प्रेजेंट
ओके 223 चेतन अवती,
मैम।
ओके 224 इलाहम इलियास प्रेजेंट,
यस मैम।
ओके 225 जयराज, 225 जयराज, ओके 226 कार्तिक संगमेश देसाई,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके 227 मोहम्मद उमर, 227 मोहम्मद उमर नियाज अहमद 227 एबसेंट, ओके 228 मोहम्मद तौकीर, 228 मोहम्मद तौकीर पिंजर एबसेंट,
यस मैम।
ओके यू आर देयर, ओके 229 मुकेश, मुकेश
यस मैम।
ओके 230 मुस्कान,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
231 प्राज्वल,
प्रेजेंट
टू थर्टी
मैम।
टू 232 प्राज्वल, बोथ टोटल 3 प्राज्वल्स आर देयर, 231 इज प्राज्वल होना शेट्टी, यू आर देयर,
यस मैम प्रेजेंट।
ओके 232 इज प्राज्वल महेश पायलट, यू आर देयर,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके एंड 233 इज प्राज्वल पाटिल, प्राज्वल पाटिल नॉट देयर, ओके 234
प्रेजेंट मैम। प्रेजेंट
प्रमोद, 235 सचिन, सचिन 235 नॉट देयर, 236 सहाना,
मैम।
237 समीक्षा,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
238 शरणप्पा,
यस मैम।
239 शिखा,
यस मैम।
ओके 240 शुभम,
यस मैम।
ओके 241 सिद्धार्थ,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
242 सोमेश,
प्रेजेंट
243 सूरज,
मैम।
244 स्वाति,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
245 विद्याश्री,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके 246 विजयलक्ष्मी,
यस मैम।
ओके 247 गौतमी, 247 गौतमी एब्सेंट, 248 लक्ष्मी,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके 249 मडयप्पा,
यस मैम।
ओके 250 प्रेरणा,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके 251 मनोज कोपर,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके 252 नेहा पाटिल,
यस मैम।
ओके 253 प्रद्युम्ना, 253 प्रद्युम्ना पाटिल, 253 प्रद्युम्ना, नॉट देयर. 254 वेदिका,
प्रेजेंट मैम.
ओके. 255 श्रीनिवास, श्रीनिवास,
प्रेजेंट
ओके
मैम. प्रेजेंट मैम प्रेजेंट.
ओके ओके. Thank you, students. I think your next class will be waiting. You can leave now. I'll be giving you this meeting recording soon. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.